Mr. and Lady Day, Billie Holiday and the Dog Who Loved Her, a Literally Cultured Read Aloud, written by Amy Novesky and illustrated by Vanessa Brantley Newton. Billie Holiday loved to sing. As a girl, she sang along to her favorite songs on a borrowed gramophone. She dreamed of being a star. And a star she became, the Great Lady Day. But sometimes stars don't feel like shining. They need someone to listen. That's what friends are for. Lady Day's dogs were her best friends of all. There were lots of dogs in Lady Day's life. The poodle she carried in her coat pocket, and the brown and white beagle. The Chihuahuas, Chiquita and Pepe, she fed with a baby bottle. There was the Great Dane named Gypsy and the wire-haired terrier Bessie May Mucho, who wagged her tail like a metronome. Raja Ravoy, the sad mutt she gave the grandest name, would wander off, but he always found his way home. And then there was a boxer named Mister. Mister and Lady Day were rarely apart. She knit him sweaters and cloaked him in a mink coat. She cooked for him and took him on midnight walks. She sang to him, "Sugar, I call my baby Sugar." Mister was Lady's favorite. Someday she'd have a house in the country filled with dogs. Life would be good. Mister would be there. He always was. When Lady performed at glamorous Harlem clubs, Mister sat beside her before the show. Porters brought him plates of thick steak and bowls of water. Later, he stayed with Lady in her dressing room while she pinned flowers to her hair. He kept fans at a polite distance. When it was time for her to sing, Mister would lead a nervous Lady to the stage and wait for her in the wings. Lady was famous for singing the blues. But the sadness of her songs didn't matter to Mister. As long as he could hear her, he was happy. Then, just when her career was at the top, Lady got into trouble. She had to leave home for a year and a day, and Mister couldn't come. Lady knew what it was like to be left, and it made her heart sick. She promised Mister she'd be home soon. But when she looked into his sad eyes, she wasn't sure she'd ever see him again. While Lady was gone, she wrote letters and knit sweaters, but she did not sing. Singing was about feeling, and she didn't feel a thing. When it was finally time to return, she wondered if Mr. would be there. Would he remember her at all? Then there he was. Running down the platform, Mr. leaped on Lady, knocking her down. Someone screamed and everyone scattered. But soon a crowd gathered. It's Billie Holiday! And Lady's homecoming was as bright as a paparazzo's flashbulb. Lady couldn't go home just yet. On the front porch at a friend's farm, she rehearsed. It was time for her to sing again, whether she felt like it or not. In just 10 days, she'd have her biggest show ever at New York City's Carnegie Hall. Lady was afraid. She'd heard the rumor that the great Billie Holiday was through. Was it true? On the night of the big show, the concert hall glowed. At midnight, the house lights dimmed and a spotlight as full as the moon appeared. Slowly, Lady walked to center stage, the hall so quiet you could hear her heels click. Lady trembled. Where was Mr.? Was he waiting in the wings? As the band's notes began, Lady lifted her chin. And when the great Billie Holiday sang, everyone and a dog held their breath and listened. And I'm thinking, if you were mine, I'd never let you go.